Shalom Israel, this is Bishop Nathaniel. The Israelites have been scattered across the four corners of the earth, as prophesied in Deuteronomy, the 20th chapter. Here at Israel United in Christ, we need your help to recover the remnant of our people, teach them the gospel. Please help us, support us, and join or donate to the Booster Club today. Shalom.
Good conditions.
That's idolatry because we are a rebellious people.
Right now. So you ever ask, like, why do we get persecuted? How can we get
brass?
But our people are so destroyed, they actually think that this is normal. This is not normal. You know, it's not normal to be out here with trash all over the place. You got bullet holes at the bus stop. You got people passed out, either drunk or on drugs. This is not normal. This is a bad condition. So why do we live like this? The brother's going to show you. Just give him a few minutes. Show him why we curse so he can understand the importance of knowing who you are. And more importantly, what we can do to lift these curses, because that's what he's teaching. What you gonna do in the kingdom?
Right now, if we were reading who the Israelites were, who they were going to be today's term, all right? And I want you to listen to this one scripture real quick.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 46. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder.
Hey, jump up to 45 real quick, so just so you can get the whole context of what it's saying.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 45. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee and overtake thee till thou be destroyed.
So the subject we're talking about is the curses of God, all right? So the curses were going to be, they were placed on the Israelites, all right? And the scripture says they were going to come upon thee and overtake thee until they pursue thee, all right?
Because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God to keep his commandments and his statutes which he commanded thee. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder.
So if you're still with me, bro, what was going to be upon these people for a sign and a wonder?
Brother.
Yeah.
It's me and you, right?
Okay. Where you from? Sierra Leone. So where that would be, so if like, okay, West Africa, okay. Go ahead.
If I don't have the definition of a true Israelite.
Uh-huh. Black American. So you wouldn't consider yourself an Israelite?
I mean, I was born in Africa, but I think you guys will bring over to slavery.
Okay, so let's go to
Give me James 1:1. Because
you know why? I got a video.
Hold on. Luke. Yeah, get that in Luke. So no, he was saying that he's from West Africa. So you said Sierra Leone?
Yeah.
Sierra Leone. So what we're gonna show you is that you too are an Israelite according to the Bible, because I mean, there would be no consider more. We're all the same people. You see what I'm saying? So he's not a higher Israelite than you. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to show you that, you know what I'm saying, you too are an Israelite, because everybody, all Israelites weren't brought over here, all right? Some stayed over in Africa, all right?
Not that definition, though. Because my definition of Israelite, what the Bible told me, my mother and father is Christian. What the Bible told me, like, something will change your name.
I'm gonna read the scripture. Hold on.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
So it says, thy sons and thy daughters, meaning, so if your son and your daughter was given to people over in America for slavery, right? You see what I'm saying? You still are an Israelite. Because we were given, you still are the same. You understand it? Read.
And thine eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long.
Because that's what happened, man. When we came over here, some of our people, brother, they seen us and they were longing for us, and there was nothing that they couldn't do, all right? Yeah. Yeah. Because we were actually picked up from where?
All of Africa.
The west coast of Africa, brother. That's where we came. That's where we picked up those tribes in those areas. When we look,
and one thing for sure, Africa, west coast of Africa. My country.
I'm gonna show you this. Actually, we have a.
My country, where I come from. You can start anywhere in my country and see the
people. And look, so
it's easy for them to just pick up anybody.
Exactly. Look, but what you have to understand is that we're not Africans. You know what I'm saying? Africa. Yeah.
Right here,
and that's where we were
right
picked
here,
up from,
right
as
here,
you can see.
Right here, right
we were picked up and we were brought over here to America.
Most black people came from this town right here.
Yeah, all of this is the West Coast.
My country's right here. When you stand right here, you can see anywhere in the ocean. In my country, anywhere in the ocean.
All right, bro, so what are you trying to say about Sierra Leone? What are you saying again?
Most people were taken from this side.
Yeah, most of the Israel, we were taken from all of Africa. The majority wasn't the West Coast. Read this for me. But we were in all of Africa. I'll prove that to you. Because from fleeing Jerusalem, we fled here into Africa and we spread mostly to the West Coast.
Yep.
But still, you gotta understand that the Hamites, Africans, are still different from us. There's a difference. Hold on, I'm about to read this for you. Read. Tell me the book.
This is the book, From Babylon to Timbuktu, by Rudolph R. Windsor.
So we're using this to back up the scriptures.
Master Musa.
Okay. No, we're not reading about him right now. I'm reading about something else. Read that.
Page 84. In the year 65 BC, the Roman armies under General Pompey captured Jerusalem.
So they captured Jerusalem, where was our homeland, which is right up here in Israel. We were there first.
In 70 AD.
So 70 years after the death of Christ, 70 AD.
General Vespasian and his son, Titus, put an end to the Jewish state.
That's when they sacked Jerusalem and destroyed our city.
With great slaughter. During the period of the military governors of Palestine, many...
So with the Palestine, meaning the Arabs, the Palestinians. So the so-called white men and the Arabs worked together to destroy our city.
Many outrages and atrocities were committed against the residue of the people.
Here, Rita.
During the period from Pompey to Julius, it has been estimated that over 1 million Jews fled...
Over what?
1 million Jews...
So over 1 million Jews, which were black and are black just like us...
Fled into Africa.
Fled into Africa, bro. So that's how we got into the country of Africa. We fled from Jerusalem into Africa. That's how we got there.
So your ancestors got there too.
Millions of Israelites who escaped the persecution of the Roman-Jewish War fled into the interiors of Africa. You've got to ask yourself, why did the Israelites run to Africa? The same reason why the parents of the Messiah fled to Egypt. To blend in. They were black and needed to blend in with other dark-skinned people. Rudolph R. Windsor, in his book Babylon to Timbuktu, points out, the black Jews who migrated to the Sudan from the north converged with the black Jews migrating from the eastern Sudan to the countries of the Niger River. There is much proof, and still much more to be revealed by scholars, that there existed prior to the slave trade and subsequent to it many tribes, colonies, and kingdoms in West Africa. Page 120. 1600 years later, their descendants were rounded up and captured by African and the Arabs slave traders and sold to the Europeans, fulfilling the curses that were written in Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter.
Fleeing from Roman persecution and slavery, the slave markets were full of black Jewish slaves.
So yes, you're right. The slave markets were full of black Jewish slaves that were living in Africa. Like me, my pops is from Nigeria too. But we weren't from there. We intermingled with the Hamites that were there. So get the other page. Talked about us when we were living there. Because even though we were living in their country, we were still separate from them. Read that. Read from the top right there.
Page 90. By what factors can we explain the emergence of black Hebrew hegemony and leadership over the indigenous tribes?
You heard that? Black Hebrew leadership over the indigenous, meaning the people that were there first. We were leading over the Africans that were there in that country when we came there.
The answer is simple.
Uh-huh.
The Jews came into the Western Sudan from Northern and Eastern Africa.
So we ventured, after we flew from Jerusalem, we started going into different parts of Africa.
As a result of a chain of commercial and persecutory migrations. For many centuries, the Hebrews had to employ great physical and psychological initiative. They could not afford to be complacent or apathetic.
So basically, we weren't just sitting there being, bro, you listening? So we weren't just in Africa sitting there docile. We were always doing better for ourselves. We weren't just sitting there being subservient people. We were building nations while we were in Africa.
They were hated, so apathy could mean cultural stagnation or death. The black Jews
in Africa
had an advantage over the African tribes.
We had an advantage over the African tribes, showing that we're different from them. Because my pops from Nigeria, I've met certain Africans who treat me like dirt because they think I'm just a regular African American. They figure out I'm from Nigeria, they start treating me with respect. And you know that. You know certain Africans treat black people wrong. So that's the truth. Because we're not the same people. That's why they treat us like that. Exactly, but the dumb ones mostly aren't our people. Because when I was growing up in school, most of the West Africans hang out with the black people. Why? Because we're the same people. Exactly. Some are brainwashed, but some are heathens. Some are actually Hamites. I'm going to prove that to you. We're different later with the script after I'm done reading this.
They carried their culture, history, laws, and written records with them.
So we carried all our culture and our history into Africa. That's why a lot of West Africans follow what they call Jewish culture, which is really Israelite culture that we do today. They keep the Sabbath, they circumcise, they do certain things that the Israelites did because we brought that culture with us into Africa.
This assured them a constant precedent for the development of a higher social organization. Because of the stability of the black Jewish culture.
Because what the laws give us what? They give us structure, organization. That's what they give us.
The Jews were not absorbed into the autochthonous population.
So, because even though we lived in West Africa, we didn't get absorbed into all of the Hamite cultures. We had our own culture that we brought there, and we flourished with that.
In fact, the Jews absorbed some of the native tribes.
So in fact, some of them started following what we did.
The Jews made use of every opportunity. They were an industrious and skillful people. And the Jewish guardian states were found kings, princes.
Read that again.
And the Jewish guardian states, the Jews made use of every opportunity. They were an industrious and skillful people.
We were an industrious and skillful people. Think about it. Who built America? Who built the pyramids? Who built destruction in Europe? We built it all. So that shows we were never a dumb savage people. We were always intelligent. But over time goes, the white man changed the history books and says we were savages, we have no clothes. All that's make us think we're lesser than we really are.
If you look at the white man only have history about like 300-400 years now.
Right, brother. The thing is, the white man, they're the two cavemen. They're the two cavemen, because whenever you ever seen a movie with cavemen and they were black?
Bring it up.
Never, because they were the ones living, in the mountains. Keep reading.
And the Jewish Ghanaian states were...
And I'm going to prove that too when I'm done here.
And the Jewish Ghanaian states were found
kings,
princes, governors, generals.
So we had a structure to we had a structure to guide our people, to instruct our people, to govern our people before the white man's government was created. Most of the stuff that they have, bro, they took from us. They stole from us and started instituting everything themselves. Think of the word judicial. Where does that come from? Jewish, Judah.
Secretaries, treasurers,
revenues.
So we knew how to handle money. And this is back, bro, this is back way before any of us was born, hundreds of years ago.
Revenue agents,
judges,
architects,
engineers,
doctors.
And this was in Africa. When we were scattered in Africa, we were holding these professions.
Historians, language interpreters,
mathematicians.
Jewelers, sculptors, masons,
keep going,
carpenters,
right,
painters of art, goldsmiths, leather workers, potters, armorers, saddlers,
blacksmiths,
agriculturalists, and etc.
So all those things, bro, all those professions we was holding when we was in Africa, we knew how to do those things. We were never a dumb, savage race, ever. But get Exodus 11 and 7. So I'm going to show you, that's what the Jews, that's what we brought that to Africa.
We always, kings and stuff like that. We always have
Right. The resource was always good. But remember, we're Israelites. We're not Africans. We lived in Africa, but we're just like we live in America. Are you American? No, we're just living in that land. Exactly, we're not. So I'm going to prove to you. Hold that. Get Galatians 4 and 26. First, I'm going to prove to you what our motherland is. Yes, Jerusalem is in the northern part of Africa. It is there, but still we're Israelites. Read that for me. I know you gotta go. Give me like six more minutes. 5 minutes. All right. That's all I need.
This is the book of Galatians, chapter 4, verse 26. But Jerusalem.
By Jerusalem.
Which is above is free. Which
what?
Is the mother of us all.
You heard that, bro?
Read that again.
But Jerusalem, which is above, is free, which is the mother of us all.
Proving Jerusalem is the motherland, not Africa. Get Exodus 11 and 7 to prove to you that Africans and Israelites are a different race, a different people.
This is the book of Exodus, chapter 11, verse 7.
And I'm saying that as a person whose father is from Nigeria, and I know this difference between African-American blacks and Africans. That's according to the Bible.
But against any of the children of Israel.
So against any of the children of Israel, so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans,
shall not a dog move his tongue.
So a dog shouldn't speak against us. And who else?
Against man or beast. That ye may know how that the Lord doth put a difference.
So the Most High God put a difference between what?
Between the Egyptians.
Between the Egyptians who are what was the whole continent of Africa called back in the day? It was called Egypt, Mizraim. So the whole continent was called Egypt. So hold on, listen, that's talking about the whole, all the Africans. Because Egypt, what does that mean?
And Egypt is a name for the Chemites or something?
Yep, what does Egypt mean? To constrict. Egypt, that's why it's called Egypt, because we were in slavery there. That's what Egypt means. Mizraim means to constrict or to hold. That's why we were in the 400 years of slavery there, and we were in slavery here again today too. Keep reading.
The Lord doth put a difference between the Egyptians and Israel.
And the Israelites. There's a difference between us and the Africans. I got something else for you too.
The deceiving of the black race. Black Egyptians enslaved black Israelites.
You heard that?
Black Egyptians enslaved black Israelites.
So just because our skin color, listen, just because our skin color is the same doesn't mean we're the same people. You see some Indians blacker than us. East Indians, Chinese, are they the same people as us? No, they're not. It's just the skin color doesn't determine your nationality.
Did you get a fly?
Yeah, I got my fly.
Okay, good.
Wait,
that was it?
Yes. Get me Joel 3, Joel 2. So I'm going to show you how the white man and the Arabs and the Africans came together and sold us. I'm so here too.
Are you going to be here next Saturday?
Yes, every Saturday, weather permit, you're going to be here. Okay, I'll praise. Thanks, I appreciate it. Okay, listen to this real quick.
This is the book of Joel, chapter 3, verse 4. Yea, and what have ye to do with me, O Tyre and Zidon?
So Tyre and Zidon are two ancient African kingdoms. They came from the lineage of Tyre and Zidon were two Hamite children, and they had kingdoms in Africa. So the Most High God is saying, what have you to do with me? I'm not your God. What do you want from me? I got nothing to do with y'all. Let's see what he says. And all the coast of Palestine. And all the coast of Palestine is speaking about the Arabians. Get the sign for me. What was it? So that's speaking about the so-called Arabians, the Middle Easterners. And there you go. We about to saw it right here. A lot of people don't know that. And they follow Islam. Yeah, and they follow Islam, but those are first slave captives. Islam is just as bad as Christianity, if not worse. Keep reading.
Will ye render me a recompense?
Uh-huh.
And if ye recompense me.
So the recompense is like, are you going to slay my people because I'm not your God? Now what is the Most High God going to say?
And if ye recompense me.
If you try to come against me by enslaving my people.
Swiftly uh-huh. and speedily uh-huh. will I return your recompense upon your own head.
So when Christ come back, the same things the white man and the Arabs did to us is going to happen to them. The same thing. Keep reading. I believe it for
sure. That's true. Yes, sir.
Because ye have taken my silver and my gold uh-huh. and have carried into your temples my goodly pleasant things.
So the silver and gold is a metaphor referring because they did steal our jewelry. They did steal stuff out of our temple, but they took us too. We're precious to the Most High God and they stole us and sold us. Keep reading.
The children also of Judah.
So the children of Judah, which is your so-called African Americans, your Caribbeans, and your Haitians.
And the children of Jerusalem.
And the children of Jerusalem are your Hispanics, your Cubans, your Dominicans, your Mexicans, your Native Americans. That's them.
Have ye sold unto the Grecians.
So the Africans and the Arabs sold us to the Grecians. Who are the Grecians? Who's from Greek?
Europeans.
So-called what? The white man. Go get that.
This is the book of Galatians, chapter 6, verse 7.
Uh-huh.
Be not deceived.
Uh-huh.
God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap.
So whatever you do, you're going to get that. You know what they say? The karma, whatever you put out, you're going to get back. That's from the scriptures too. So whatever they did to us, read that again.
This is the book of Galatians, chapter 6, verse 7.
Uh-huh.
Be not deceived.
So don't be fooled. Don't think you're going to get away with it.
God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth,
uh-huh.
that shall he also reap.
Yes, sir.
For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption.
All right, go back to Joel. Finish that up.
This is the book of Joel.
Okay. Next one.
Chapter 3, verse 6.
Uh-huh.
The children also of Judah
uh-huh.
and the children of Jerusalem
uh-huh.
have ye sold unto the Grecians.
So the Bible just proved that the Africans and Arabs got together, enslaved the so-called blacks during the sub-Saharan slave trade, and sold them to the Grecians. And that started the transatlantic slave trade. So yes, the white man had us in slavery, but first the Arabs and Africans enslaved us, killed us, raped us, cut off our limbs, and forced us to follow Islam.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone, 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.